随着金融诈骗案件的日益严重，中老年受害者占据了相当大的比例。这类案件通常涉及大额资金，给受害者带来了巨大的经济损失。为了应对这一问题，多年来致力关怀亚裔社群的基督教角声医疗中心与美国证券交易委员会 SEC 合作，于17日在艾尔蒙蒂总部合办一场国语讲座及新闻发布会，提醒长者如何保护辛苦积存下来的财产，免受诈骗之害。
Fortunately, seniors are a targeted community, and that's for the reasons that Jinling said. You know, a lot of times they're alone, a lot of times they face a language barrier, and a lot of times they are more trusting than they should be. So I think as a child of somebody that's old,elderly, I try to be involved as much as I can in my parents' financial well-being, which isn't to say that I want to make their business my business, but it really is, you know, incumbent on me. It's my obligation to care for them as they reach this stage in their life and be there as a resource to answer any questions and also to, you know, be a nag, to ask questions of my own, even when they're not posing those questions to me.Because, you know, nobody should be in this by themselves. And that's why you do see communities being targeted for investment fraud.
That's investor.gov, so .gov. And there's a lot of information there for people who are looking to make investments. They'll talk about various red flags of fraud that you can be on the lookout for to help you make a safe investment and really to understand what you're investing in. So there's a lot of frequently asked questions on there and ways that you can look up to see if your offering is registered or if the broker dealer or investment advisor that you're working with, the professional you're working with, is registered, which is really something that is very important to do your own research. So if someone callsNot just to take that person at their word, but to say, you know, I'm not going to be pressured. I'm going to hang up the phone. I'm going to do my own research and look these people up. And investor.gov is one way you can do that.
马俊玲律师向与会者提出了几个预防意见。他表示，如果接到可疑电话，应立即挂断并自行联系相关机构，核实对方身份，切勿通过来电号码直接回拨。如遇到自称为中国大陆警员或其他官方人员的来电，也不要轻信。请及时联系家人并咨询专业人士。